Good morning. Welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Church of Birmingham. Whoever you are, whomever you love, wherever you are today, and wherever you are on your spiritual journey, you are welcome here. Today's service is inspired by General Assembly 2020, the national meeting of Unitarian Universalists from all over the world. The theme was Rooted, Inspired, and Ready, and specifically called attention to our relationship to First Nations within our country. Today, we honor the lessons learned at General Assembly and celebrate our First Nations in several ways in preparation for Indigenous Peoples Day tomorrow. To all who are here this morning, welcome home.
If you would like to participate in today's service, especially during our sharing of joys and sorrows, please use the chat feature in YouTube. We also invite you to send virtual hugs and waves to one another using parentheses around someone's name. After church today, we invite you into our Zoom room for coffee hour, small groups, and meetings. Please check out the announcements for this week. Please take a moment to hear a message by our Share the Plate recipient, the Unitarian Universalist Office at the United Nations.
At a time when nationalism is so dominant around the world, having a Unitarian Universalist voice represented at the United Nations is more critical than ever. The Unitarian Universalist Association Office at the United Nations has held a prominent place at the UN since 1962, advocating for UU values on the global stage. By engaging every day with member states and agencies and speaking out in defense of human rights for those who are oppressed, the UU office has become a force to be reckoned with at the UN. The UU at UN's advocacy and coalition building helped to make sexual orientation and gender identity human rights a priority throughout the UN system. And we continue to be a leader on sexual orientation and gender identity issues within the UN human rights community. This year, our office is focused on bringing the global community together to share solutions for demilitarizing local police forces and to amplify just and inclusive ways to keep communities safe. Through our affiliation with the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, the UU office at the UN gets credentials for observers to represent Unitarian Universalists and participate in the annual UN climate conferences. In recent years, we have prioritized getting passes for Indigenous and frontline climate activists who are so often excluded from these intergovernmental conferences. We know that the international community must come together to solve global problems like climate change, but that governments aren't necessarily the ones who have the right solutions. Solutions need to come from communities that are most impacted by the changing climate. And the UUA office at the UN is proud to help representatives of these communities get to international gatherings so that their perspectives can be heard at the decision-making tables. None of this work would be possible without the generous support of Unitarian Universalists. Right now, those who represent the United States at the UN are working hard to destroy protections for human rights, for the environment, and for global cooperation. Make sure that you still have someone at the UN who's committed to upholding your values and interests. The UU office at the UN relies on congregational and individual donations to continue its work advocating for a world community with peace, liberty, and justice for all.
The prelude prepares us for worship.
Thank you.
If you have a chalice with you at home, please light it now and type "lighting my chalice" in the chat feature. We light this flame to ignite the sacred power of justice. We light this flame so that it may be a beacon of hope in moments of uncertainty, fear, anxiety, and the unknown. We light this flame and are emboldened by its blaze, knowing our strength as a prophetic and powerful people is rooted in the diverse ways we answer the call to love.
Hello, church friends. This is John Bodden. As many of you know, our public radio station, WBHM, just concluded its fall fundraiser. This year, the station is making a special offer to nonprofit organizations like UUCB. It's buy one, get one free. Normally, $500 would buy about 25 mentions as a station underwriter. This year, it's 50. For $1,000, we could get mentioned on air 100 times between November and December. That's a lot of community exposure. Support comes from the Unitarian Universalist Church of Birmingham, a church that honors differences of belief. Visit them on the web at uucbham.org. And we can also present other information about our church activities and services. So if you'd like to kick a few dollars into the can for this outreach effort, please send a check made out to the church with WBHM in the memo line. Venmo works too. And remember, any money goes directly to the station, so it's a win-win. I will deliver a check with all of those monies to the station the day before Halloween. Please get in touch with me if you have any questions. Thanks.
Hi, I'm Dr. Ginger Campbell, and I've been a member of the Unitarian Universalist Church of Birmingham since 2017. Our church is supported by those who call our church home and by those who support the efforts of our church to change the world for the better. We share our cash plate every Sunday with organizations whose work reflects UU values to care for marginalized persons, advocate real and systemic change, defend our environment, and promote justice and equity for all. This month's Share the Plate is the Unitarian Universalist Association's office at the United Nations. The UUUN has a long history of providing strong leadership in all aspects of human rights at a policy level. This includes involvement in drafting the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, leading the Faith Caucus to establish the International Criminal Court, and overcoming UN apathy about sexual orientation and gender identity issues. During this time of social distancing and online worship, know that church expenses continue. So we very much appreciate you continuing to pay your pledge or make donations, either by sending a check to the church office or via PayPal or Venmo. Our account at Venmo is at UUCBHAM. May we give in love and hope.
As we enter our meditative space this morning, we invite you to lift up David Brenner and his family on the loss of his mother last week. Please send your cards and condolences to David using the address found in the directory. We also celebrate the birth of Eleanor Jane, affectionately known as Nora, child of Becca and James Rogers, who was born 2 weeks ago. Please send your cards and greetings and welcomes to the address found in the directory. Using the chat feature in YouTube, by speaking it aloud, or by hearing it on your heart, please give voice to what is on your heart today. Please hear this spoken meditation by Reverend Jude Geiger, followed by a moment of silence. The moment of silence will be followed by a meditative piece by the Tsay Ki Dene Nation of British Columbia in honor of Indigenous Peoples Day. Spirit of life, God of many names, source of hope, we come together at the end of another week. Some worn down by struggles of health, of home, or work. May we be a community that makes space for the sharing of joys and sorrows, angers and hopes, with grace and forbearance. In our nation's life, we pause this holiday weekend to remember the Native American lives lost from the European colonization on what is now our soil. Teach us to remember our history. Though we cannot make amends for what has come before, may we learn from those ways, never to repeat them in our lives today. May we develop new ways of relating to neighbor and stranger, without violence or coercion, deceit or greed. Mother of Grace, help us to find a sense of humility where we have privilege, and strength where we face oppression. And in our power, may we learn temperance. As a community of faith, may we be a safe harbor in a world that is often harsh toward difference. Challenge us to use our presence as a healing force for justice and equity, knowing that although we have come far in the civil rights struggles of our times, there are many people who are still left behind, and the work of building the beloved community is just as pressing as ever before. Blessed be.
Clouds is a place we roamed. The land. redirected down a different path. Our people didn't have a choice as we're thinking back. Is there respect for the land where we fish and trap?
Survivors of the valley, the language lives. Revival of Sicani, tradition gives. Down desire, more hope, more medicine. Giving us strength for the future to spread our wings.
Beyond the rocks, the shores and trees, to heal the wounds, the stars and broken dreams. Broken dreams. Beyond the rocks, there's more to see.
Need a little change, fresh spark of fire. We can't stay the same. What the heart desires, smoke signals to the world as it gets higher. Can't say we never made it, cause we are survivors.
The young generation, the choice is ours. The voice of a nation, we got the power. As the pain fades away, let it rain and shower. We were the calm before the storm, now we're getting louder.
They say it's all business, I call it destruction. Money breeding greed and causing corruption. Our culture is key and brings honest discussion. Say gay is independent, the truth we're becoming.
Heart not my past, mind is the present. Talk to the elders, our eyes are reflected. Fast forward to the now, find your direction. Make better choices, the future's where we're headed.
Beyond the rocks, the shores and trees, to heal the wounds, the stars and broken dreams.
Broken dreams.
Broken dreams.
Broken dreams.
Beyond the rocks, there's more to see. The leaders of the valley, we're born to be.
Born to be.
Born to be.
Born to be.
Every demon that I couldn't hide, all the deadly pain that was buried deep inside was keeping me from finding the only reason I
needed in my life, to share but forgive. Our tradition we live, we will dare to begin. Go beyond all the changes, you fly over mountains, you hear the Sake youth united and shouting.
Beyond the rocks, the shores and trees, to heal the moon, the stars and broken dreams.
Broken dreams.
Broken dreams. Beyond the rocks, there's more to see. The leaders of the valley, we're born to be.
Born to be.
Born to be.
Born to be.
Beyond the rocks, the shores and trees, to heal the wounds, the scars and broken dreams.
Broken dreams.
Broken dreams.
Broken dreams.
Beyond the rocks, there's more to see. The leaders of the valley, we're born to be.
Born to be.
Born to be.
Hi, everybody. Will the children please come forward? Hi. Today I want to tell you a story about Isato Sese and how she inspired me. Isato Sese lives in the Gambia, which is a small country on the continent of Africa. And every day she would travel from her small village into the marketplace to buy fruits and vegetables for her family. They were hard to carry, so she had a basket that she wore on her head. One day the basket fell off her head and broke. What was she going to do? Well, she found a plastic bag. She was so excited. She took that plastic bag and she put her fruits and vegetables into the bag. And now they were easy to carry. When she brought the bag home, she excitedly showed it to her grandma. Grandma, look what I found. Grandma said, that's plastic. That's not good for Gambia. But Isato was a young girl, and she didn't listen. She just knew she had found an easy way to carry home her fruits and vegetables. Then one day, she was happily swinging her bag as she walked along, and it broke. But no problem. She just threw the bag on the side of the road, and just like everybody else in Gambia did, and she went and she found herself another plastic bag. Then one day, as Isato was traveling to the market, she noticed that the pile of bags had grown bigger and bigger. She didn't like that, but she didn't think too much about it. As the years went by, the piles grew even larger. Then one day, Isato came home and noticed that two of the family goats were missing. When she asked Grandma, "Grandma, what happened to the goats?" Grandma said, "Isato, remember I told you about those plastic bags? When people throw those away, sometimes there's a little bit of food in there. And the goats like to rummage through the bags to get to the food. Sometimes they eat the bags, and then the bags wrap around their intestines, and unfortunately, they die." Well, Isato felt so sad. And I started feeling sad when I heard this story, because during the pandemic, I've been ordering my groceries online. And every time I ask them to put the food into paper bags, they still bring me all these plastic bags. And I don't want them to end up in a landfill somewhere. And the city I live in does not have a recycling program. So I've just been shoving these under my kitchen sink. And I have quite a pile of them. Well, Isato, feeling very bad, she looked at the big piles of trash and thought, "What can I do?" One day she saw the women in her village weaving, and she got an idea. She said, "I'm going to go and collect all those plastic bags. I'm going to wash them, dry them, cut them into strips, and I'm going to make something out of them." She fashioned herself a crochet hook out of an old broomstick, and she crocheted a real bag that she could then carry all her fruits and vegetables in, something that looked like this. The great thing about that was that it was waterproof and strong, and it wouldn't break no matter how heavy the fruits and vegetables that she put in it were. Not only did she come up with a solution for carrying her fruits and vegetables, other people noticed the bag and thought that it was a great idea. So she and the other village women started making these bags and selling them at the marketplace. And Isato made enough money that she bought the family a new goat. And she helped a lot of the people in her village with the money that they made from the bags that they sold at the marketplace. So you can see that I have one of those bags that I just showed you. And that's because I was inspired by Isato's story. And I took my bags and cut them into strips and crocheted them together. So if you like this story and you want to learn more about Isato, you will find it on our Religious Ed Facebook page. And you will also find a tutorial for how to make a bag like this. And you don't necessarily have to know how to crochet to do this. So I would encourage you all to go on the UUCB Religious Edge Facebook page and see how to do this. Thank you for listening and have a great rest of the day.
And now let's sing our principal song together.
One each person is worthwhile. Two, be kind in all you do. Three, we help each other learn. Four, and search for what is true. Five, all people get a vote. Six, build just and peaceful.
Hey, everybody. Hey, we had a great opportunity this summer to attend the the UUA General Assembly, and it was very unique in that it was totally virtual, of course, with COVID making everything interesting, to put it mildly, in our lives every day. The UUA staff did an outstanding job of making the conference really worthwhile and very interesting, and it kept us engaged. My hats are off to the committee and the technical team for the UUA who put everything together. We did everything from breakout sessions to the general sessions to having entertainment throughout the day, and even in the evening there were services that took place. There were opportunities to socialize with UUs all over the country, and we really enjoyed it. It was a great experience. Here at home, we had the opportunity to set up dual laptops where Tan and I, she also was an attendee at the conference, she was able to go in one break room and I went in another break room. That way we were able to double our reach, I guess you might say. And it was just great. We had a lot of fun with it. There were some long days. We were so excited, being that it was our first time getting the opportunity to go to the GA conference, till we stayed on all day. We started out early in the morning with a cup of coffee. We went through and had lunch. We had dinner and stuck around until the wee late hours of the evening, but it was well worth it. It was well worth it. And again, hats off to the team for putting a great show together. Our little group that represented the UUCB, we had a great time communicating with each other and, you know, texting back and forth and sending messages about, you know, what sessions are we going to? What session are you going to? You know, and sharing ideas after we came out of those sessions. There were some good sessions. I mean, there were some good talks, and some of it got really deep. There were some very interesting comments that came up in the chat session. Of course, that's available through Zoom. What may not have been something that takes place in person, although I did hear it could be very interesting in person too. But the opportunity was still there for fellowship with UUs all over the United States. And we developed a relationship with the local and regional drum group, and also Blue. And we even had the opportunity to be part of the planning committee and execution of the drum regional conference that took place. So the whole experience just helped us to grow as UUs within the community. And hey, as soon as we get back to church and we're able to be in the building safely, we're going to have some visitors. We met a group from the Atlanta Unitarian Universalist Church over there, and they're interested in coming over and visiting with us, and vice versa. We would like to go over and visit with them. So overall, it was just a great experience, and if you ever get the opportunity to go and haven't been, I would highly recommend it. And I would like to thank Reverend Julie and the board for providing the opportunity for me personally to be able to attend the conference. And I look forward to being able to do it again in the future, whether it be in person or virtually.
Hi, I'm Ginger Campbell. This was my first opportunity to attend General Assembly as a delegate, and it was disappointing that the meeting had to be held virtually, but I have to say that it was very well organized. I participated in the first 2 days of the event, and the session that really stands out for me is a discussion of the book Conflagration, How the Transcendentalists Sparked the American Struggle for Racial, Gender, and Social Justice. The reason this stood out for me was because I learned some things about Unitarian history and American history that I didn't know before that are very relevant to our current times. I learned that the Transcendentalists were a very important movement within the Unitarian Church, and in fact led a lot of the abolition efforts inside the Unitarian Church. But one thing that was really important to learn was that abolition was not unreservedly supported by Unitarians. First of all, some were wealthy merchants who actually made money off the cotton trade and had something to lose. So they weren't for abolition. And then, even among abolitionists, there was a divide between those who wanted immediate emancipation and those that felt that slave owners should be compensated and that slaves would need a transition period, which was what they were doing in the British colonies at the time. So to me, this was really interesting because it showed the fact that the tension between ideals and practicalities that we continue to see today is not new.
There will be better days. There will be better days. There will be better days. There will be better days.
Let the
there will be better days.
Wash
there will be better days. There will be better days. There will be better days.
Let the wave wash
there will be better days.
Over
there will be better days. There will be better days.
I am
there will be better days. There will be better days.
Let the
there will be better days. There will be better days. There will be better days. There will be better days.
Let the wave wash
there will be better days. There will be better days. There will be better days.
Let the wave wash
there will be better days.
Me.
There will be better days. There will be better days.
I am
better days. There will be better days.
darkness extinguished the chalice together. The chalice is now extinguished, but its light lives on in the minds and hearts and souls of each of you. Carry that flame with you as you leave this place and share it with those you know, with those you love, and those you have yet to meet.